Listening to me in great sincerity. I'm on GQ's worst dress list. And I couldn't believe my ears. How could a fashionable Ollie with the best locks be on that list? So I checked the list, and Ollie is standing there proudly in his Union Jack trousers, together with Jamie Oliver, Chris Brown, and Mark Wright. But I firmly believe we have much better judgments than GQ. And my committee member told me yesterday that Ollie has been to Royal Academy of Dramatic Arts at Cambridge. So the famous Rada has notable alumni such as Sir Anthony Hopkins, Sir Roger Moore, Vivian Lee, and my favorite Clive Owen. So, having studied method acting myself at the Drama Centre London, I know how competitive and prestigious it is to be trained there and to excel from over 2,000 candidates to be the cast in Made in Chelsea. And as you all know, because of E4's latest Made in Chelsea, which has been nominated for BAFTA, and Ollie has prepared a speech for BAFTA, Ollie has become a household name, stardom. Now please join me to welcome Ollie Locke, the very ever so stylish and charming and talented Ollie.
Can I keep standing? I don't know. Stand, I'm just going to sit.
You can dance on the table.
No, I probably won't. I was at a Cambridge debate once with Kate Lawler, one big brother, and I lived in Cambridge for a year, and I was going along to the debates. The one before I went to was Stephen Hawking, which is incredible. The one after was Kate Lawler, slightly like Donatella Versace in a knee. So Kate Lawler stood on top of the lectern and kind of kicked her shoes off, and everyone's kind of at the same time was fairly frightening. I don't really know what to say today. It's an extraordinary thing to be asked to be here. When they did it with Cambridge, they said, do you want to come and speak? I said, I'd rather not, because I'd rather come with a group of people and do it. Because it's kind of all the kind of tears. Of course, you've got the debating halls here, but they wanted me to do a big debate on my own, and I didn't really know what to debate about. And so it ended up in Cambridge being, I'd rather live in Chelsea than Cambridge. Against Footlights, which they decided was a draw, which was fairly amazing because I managed to get, if you watch the show, Mark Francis, Freddie and Francis fighting against them, which are all comedy in themselves. And I think we managed to win, really. And quite happily managed to win that, I think, because they didn't quite expect it. And after I turned around and said, I'd rather live in Cambridge, I don't think they knew what to say. So I think I stumped them. Should I start with fashion? I mean, what do you want to hear? Do you want to hear who's the bitch and who's not? I mean, is that more exciting? Because I can go on to that. It's more what people want to hear, isn't it? Spencer and Kagi really shagging, who knows? I should probably start with something. I do have something prepared-ish on the way down here. I kind of wrote something in an old diary, which I'll find fairly shortly. So I better start. I lived in Oxford for a while. I was going out with a girl called Miranda years ago, and I lived on the Cowley Road for 3 years, which was extraordinary. So I've got a big thing about Oxford, and I loved it. It was more about the kebab shops, really, in the Oxford Road, Cowley Road, and getting drunk in the bridge,